said that the weak say I am strong. Way down in my heart I thought he said it wrong. But when I saw the little belief which God Almighty Son, then I marvel at the wisdom of my God. Oh, I marvel at the wisdom of my God. Oh, I marvel at the wisdom of my God. When I see the little belief which God Almighty Son, then I marvel at the wisdom of my God. When they crucified the Father's only Son, and they laid him in the tomb, they put him on. For just like the little lily, he pushed back the mighty Son, then I marveled at the wisdom of my God. Oh, I marveled at the wisdom of my God. Oh, I marvel at the wisdom of my God. When I see the little relief which is the mighty Son, then I marvel at the wisdom of my God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My dear brothers and sisters, we are back together again, physically, to celebrate the Sunday Holy Mass. And we thank God for his merciful blessings. So let us acknowledge our sins as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
We glorify you, we give you thanks. sins of the world, reaching for prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord.
Let us pray. Look upon us, O God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated as you listen to the word of God.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. The Lord has opened my ear. For my part, I made no resistance. Neither did I turn away. I offered my back to those who struck me, my cheeks to those who tore at my veil. I did not cover my face against insult and spittle. The Lord prompts my help, so that I am untouched by the insult. So too, I set my face like flint. I know I shall not be ashamed. My vindicator is here at hand. Does anyone start proceeding against me? Then let us go to court together. Who thinks he has a case against me? Let him approach me. The Lord is coming to my help. Who dares condemn me? The word of the Lord.
Christ.
Oh. He has kept my soul from death.
By the elders and the chief priests and the scribes, and to be put to death, and after 3 days to rise again. And he said all this quite openly. Then taking him aside, Peter started to remonstrate with him, but turning and seeing his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said to him, "Get behind me, Satan, because the way you think is not God's way, but man's." He called the people and his disciples to him and said, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it. But anyone who loses his life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. The gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus says to us, the way you think is not God's way, but man's. He really said that to Peter, but I am saying that today, that Jesus may perhaps be speaking to you and I. Because we are bombarded with many voices in the world. We are bombarded by the many things people are saying. And we may decide to follow the voice of people. And we have not consulted Almighty God. My dear brothers and sisters, in our decision making, in the choices that we make, we are recognizing and should recognize today that Jesus is saying to us, we need to consult Almighty God. And we have to consult God to hear what He says. Well, first of all, Jesus asks Peter a question. And the question he asks, he says, who do people say I am? And you realize everyone could have answered because they all had an answer. He said, well, some say you are Elijah. Some say you are John the Baptist. Some say that you are one of the great prophets, because they could have echoed what people say. And many times we are like that, because many times questions are asked to us and we have choices to make. But instead of consulting Almighty God to make the choice, we go along with what other people have said. That is why Jesus asks a deeper question. He says, but now you have told me what people say, but what do you say? And you realize immediately they could not answer. They could not answer. But then after, Peter was able to answer, and Peter echoed, you are the Son of God. You are the Christ. And when Peter echoed that answer, Jesus knew immediately, this is not flesh and blood, but that is the voice of God who is speaking through you. So again, we should recognize that when we ought to speak, when we ought to act, as the second reading reminds us, faith without good works is dead. So therefore, if we are people of faith, if we are doing good works, well, our direction should come from Almighty God. So Peter, if he was given a test, he alone would have gotten 100%. He may have even gotten an A+, because he gave the right answer. But then something happened very shortly after. After Jesus says to us, yes, He is the Son of Man. He is the Christ. But this Christ is going to suffer grievously and be put to death. What happened? Peter didn't consult God, because that is the will of God, that the Christ will suffer grievously and be put to death. But Peter, the same one who God has spoken to, is the same Peter now who does what is totally wrong. He just did what was totally right, the A+. And now he is going to do something that now he has an F-. Because he is trying to prevent Jesus from doing the will of God. Whereas Jesus made it very clear, since from a little boy, when his mother found him in the temple, "Son, I and your father were looking for you everywhere. Why are you looking for me everywhere? Don't you know I'll be about my father's business?" So here Peter wants to stop Jesus from doing the will of God, because his way is that the Christ is not to suffer. And Jesus is saying, no, the way of God is for Christ to suffer. So not because God has spoken to you in the past and you are 100% correct. Today, you could be 0% right. So you could be 100% wrong. Because even when a voice comes to you, how you're so sure it is the voice of God? You have to discern that voice to know really or not God is speaking to you. If those who at morning mass heard me preach this morning, this is a wonderful example. So we have to pick sense out of nonsense. So I'm going to use the example today, the very controversial example of vaccination. So first of all, let me put the disclaimer. All are welcome, whether you're vaccinated or unvaccinated. The church is not going to ask you to prove it. But obviously, if you come to church, we expect you to say the truth. So therefore, all are welcome. You need to understand what the church is saying. The church is saying, well, at this point in history, we need to be prudent and wise. We really don't know the effects of the coronavirus. We know that it can spread very easily, especially with all the variants in the world. So therefore, at this point in time, those who will be on the altar, and I didn't ask them for no proof, because I expect them to be truthful, those on the altar will be vaccinated. Because, yes, we know that vaccinated people can be affected as well as unvaccinated people. But the ones who can be affected faster and quicker, the one who can spread it even more easier, is the unvaccinated. So that is what the church is saying. But what I'm coming to is how we really have to listen to the voice of God. And I had a wonderful example of two persons who I know very well. So when you know people very well, you can say things and they will not be offended. And these two people came to me and they said, "Father, they upset and they vex with the church," and you know how it goes. They want to quote all sorts of statistics around the world and all sorts of voices. It's easy to say what other people say. And they said to me, and this is where we're going to pick sense from nonsense. They said to me, "Father, the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit says to them not to be vaccinated. And I smile, because that's all I can do. And I know the two individuals, and because they are young people here, I wouldn't really use the word I want to use, but I'll use a polite word. I say, you two people, you all are cohabiting. You are cohabiting. So God never tells you to get married, but God will tell you to get vaccinated. So the voice of God will negate sin. A house divided cannot stand. God will not go against himself. God will allow you to commit sin and then tell you, don't take a vaccine. God is about life. God is about doing what is good. That is why when people say the voice that they hear, this voice and the voice of the Holy Spirit, how are you going to discern it? You have to discern it with the teachings of the church. Because this reading is going to remind us yet again, the voice of the church. Jesus is going to say, you are Peter, and I am going to build my church, and the gates of hell shall never prevail. So therefore, if we have to follow any voice, there is only one true voice after the voice of Almighty God. And we have to discern when people say God talking to them. The only way we can discern it is through the teachings of the church. I know some people may not want to hear that, but pick sense out of nonsense. God is not going to allow you to continue in sin. God wants you to have life. So you say you want to preserve your life, because that is whatever. And you preserve your life, so your life is pristine, but you appear the judgment of Jesus and sin. What will happen? The other example I want to use to you, and you pick sense out of nonsense. You ever look at the American commercials when they advertise any type of tablets? There are people here who want different types of tablets. Cholesterol tablets, diabetes tablets, back pain tablets,
muscle
tablets, all sorts. And when you hear the amount of side effects in the mention, what is the first thing you say? It's better me to take that tablet. And what happened? You still take the tablet because you know it's going to help you. Everything in life will have a certain amount of side effects. Something in life is going to kill you. So therefore, we don't know what it is, but we pray to God and say, preserve me, God. I take refuge in you. So Lord, whatever I do it according to your will. And if it is the will of the church, the will of Almighty God, so therefore, if something should happen, it will follow you. We have to be truly wise. When people go for a surgery, it is always 50-50. Even if it's under local anesthesia. And you don't know the outcome, but what do? You still take the surgery and you place your trust in Almighty God. So we have to recognize that where people are dividing you from serving God and coming to church and falling out again, vex your church and say, we are going back to church. And because only certain people can be on the altar, because I'm not vaccinated, I'm not coming back to church. Who will want that? Certainly not God. A house divided will not stand, because those people, God will tell you, God will speak to you and say, don't get vaccinated. Because God knows if you're vaccinated, you won't be able to praise and worship his name. picks sense from nonsense. That is why Jesus, he picks sense from nonsense. Not because God spoke to you, Peter, and said to you that I am the Christ. Not because God had spoken to you then, what you are saying now. Jesus is saying, you ain't really making sense. That is why he told him, get behind me, Satan. Because Satan is the one who keeps us in sin. Satan is the one who prevents us from worshiping and praising God in spirit and in truth. Jesus is about life. The word of God you hear this evening is all about life. So we're supposed to be doing the things to preserve life. My dear brothers and sisters, I know you may not have this. I have gone to the hospital where there are COVID patients. It is a horrible situation to see. It is a horrible situation when you know that people have died. And here we have an opportunity. Even if we say an opportunity to preserve life, we don't know what the future, and the church says we don't know what is the long-term effect, but we know at least now, even if we do this, we may get the virus, but we will end up for a long time in a hospital bed. And we have a greater opportunity for life. So we have to really choose life always. There are many people who say they know. The only one who knows is Almighty God. So we consult God in everything. And when we are uncertain, the one to discern that, follow the teachings of the church. Follow the teachings of the church. Remember, Jesus warned us. Many will come. Many will come, but they will be in sheep clothing. But he said, he promises, the gates of hell shall never prevail. The church, yes, in the past, and the church will continue to make errors because it has human beings, and human beings are prone, they are weak, they will make errors, but the church is divine. So that's why we need to trust the church. Even good people, Peter was a good man. He really heard the voice of the Lord. Even Jesus acknowledged, this was revealed to you by God. But then, afterwards, he really speaks some stupidness. And Jesus needed to tell him, get behind me, Satan. So your cross, my cross is, we don't know the future of this vaccine. So the cross is the table. That's the cross. But when you take it, you are doing what we can do now. That is the best you can do. I'm not trying to convince you, but I am putting it before you. Pick sense from nonsense. The only one who will prevent you from doing anything that is good is evil. Because we are called to be a people of faith. So don't put your trust in no man. Put your trust in God. But God, likewise, he spoke to our whole church. He founded a church. And he says, when you're unsure, listen to the voice of the church. Because I have made a promise, the gates of hell shall never be prevailed. So to my dear brothers and sisters, I'm not saying the way that they are going about to help people understand the vaccination is the right way. I'm not saying that they have unrolled this properly. But what I'm saying, the reality is, every vaccination in the world, whether modern day or past, they all have side effects. Every medicine you're taking right now has side effects. Every time you go before a doctor, who is to say the doctor is going to diagnose you with the right symptoms? Because, and they give you what you place your trust in God, because God is healer God. His ways are not man's ways. And God is not a God of division. So I welcome everyone back. Everyone, let us not bring about a foolish divide, but let us really recognize that we are the people of God. God will bless us, He will keep us, He will watch over us. All we need to do is try and continue to try, always doing what is right and good. Amen. So we have heard the word of God. We have reflected on it. At this time, let us stand and pray. But before we pray, let us profess the creed we believe in. So we use the Apostles' Creed. That is the creed said at the start of the Most Holy Rosary. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into heaven. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. As we gather to celebrate the mystery of our salvation, let us turn to God the Father with confidence and implore His mercy. So we pray this Holy Mass in a special way for Jeanette Elias, for healing, for the usurp and youth ministry as they celebrate their 10th anniversary in Thanksgiving, and the Thanksgiving of St. Benedict College, their 65th anniversary. We also pray in a very special way for those who have died, that God will forgive them their sins and welcome them into eternal kingdom, as we lift up Norma Kimlin Govaya, Luke Tajidi, Molly Jagasa. Lord, hear us.
We pray for the church. We pray that the church may be a beacon of light and a sign of hope in the world for all who are suffering. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
That Christians may follow in the footsteps of Christ by accepting their daily crosses in imitation of the suffering of Jesus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
That God may comfort and console those who are finding their crosses heavy and burdensome. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For the sake of our community, that they may see in their illness a splinter of the cross of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For relatives and friends who have gone before us in faith, may they be in the presence of Christ who triumphs over suffering and death. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
let us pause for a moment in silence for our own personal needs to God, our loving Father.
So loving and merciful God, we thank you for these our prayers, those that are loud and silent in our hearts, that you've been a loving God will grant our petitions, if it is for your glory and honor, as we make all our prayer with the intercession of Mary, our Mother of Perpetual Health, Saint Joseph, our Protector, Saint Andrew Cadwell, through Jesus Christ, you give yourself faith. Please be seated at this time. We have the collection and the preparation of peace. Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offering, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and of a range of changings of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you at joyful celebration, we acclaim. divine being, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the people, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may gather into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jason, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your peace. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we have merit to request eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostle, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant you peace and unity. In accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. My dear brothers and sisters, just a reminder, in receiving Holy Communion, you are to come up pew by pew, maintaining your distance from the person in front of you, and you sanitize your hands to receive the Holy Communion, the Blessed Sacrament. Let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us. Through Christ our Lord. Please remain standing. So my dear brothers and sisters, I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate all our young children who wrote the secondary entrance assessment, and they have gone to the secondary school of their choice. If you did not go to a school of your choice, make the best of it. Because at the end of your secondary school experience, it is the same examination you will be writing. So congratulations to all of you that you survived even during the time of COVID-19, a pandemic. And also those who are moving to Form 2. I know some of you have never even seen your Form 1 classroom. And now you're going to Form 2, so you don't even know. You still haven't seen it yet. But God will preserve you. Place your trust in God. Likewise, we have returned to all our masses at the usual time. So during the week, the morning masses, you can register at the door. But definitely the weekend masses, because of the number of people requesting masses, please do it online at catholictt.org or call the office if you cannot do it for yourself. Tomorrow there will be 4 masses in this church. So 1 at 6 a.m., 8 a.m., 10 a.m., 3 p.m., sorry, and 6 p.m. So there will be 5 masses tomorrow. 6, 8, 10, 3, and then at 6 p.m. So may God continue to preserve you and bless you. May you be able to make wise choices, and when on shore, follow the direction of the church. If you are to err with the side of the church. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Go with the peace of Christ. And we are within the protocol because I began at 6:08 and it is 7:08. As I know that you enter through one door, but when you are leaving, you can exit through any door. So therefore, because all the doors and exit can be opened from the inside. So yes, you enter through one, but you can exit through any door. So do have a blessed night, everyone. Thank you.